Look, if I were head TA, I'd let the kids do whatever they wanted. I mean, if they are paying us to be here, right? If they want to get a tattoo on their morning break, who are we to stop them?
Hey,
I'm sorry. I don't like
this. Dude, my girl went home because the mold on the ceiling.
I don't like your music. I don't like living here.
I like your face.
It's taking like 30 minutes to fall.
People keep trying to touch me.
They took my meth and they expect me to make an A.
Why does Dr. Wood always make me do his laundry?
I mean, I made a comment one time about how I make a good housewife.
You can't always get what you want, but if you try sometimes, you might find you get what you need.
We were made the guardians of the magic pen because as products of its power, we're the only ones who truly understood it.
But now that it's been stolen, the thief will have the ability to turn fact into fiction and fiction into fact at his will. We have to retrieve it before damage is irrevocably done to the world.
If we retrieve the artifacts, count me in. Where can we find it?
I found this at the pen's empty case. The thief is taunting us. He
or she. Girls can be rough too, you know.
Ow, 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 stop. Your mother wasn't a snake, was she?
He or she is somehow involved with the advanced program for young scholars. I think I should go investigate.
And what'll you do when you find the thief? You're hardly equipped to do anything more than hunt down clues. I'm at the top of my class at Hogwarts. I'll come with you in case you need a witch at your side.
If she's going, I'm going. Because girls always get themselves into trouble they need saving from.
Well, I guess I better go too to protect you from those crawfish snakes in Louisiana, Miss Jones.
Oh, I'll come too. I mean, of course I'll come five, since there are already four of you going. But if you think about it, I can't come more than once because I exist in singularity.
Jinkies.
Fine. Anyone else?
Well, I'm a great investigator, but it seems I'm blind without my glasses, and I've misplaced them.
Yo, Holmes, I come along too, but little Junior here is all about splish splash taking a bath in the hot tub that is my internal organs. So unless you want me to vom on the perp, I don't think I'll be much help.
What? I believe in being uncomfortably honest in public places.
Enough. Little Red, you keep your big eyes here and watch out for wolves dressed as friends.
What about friends dressed as wolves?
I guess keep your eyes out for them too. Ed, you help her out. Anyone comes near you, slice them and dice them.
Can't I just give them a nice haircut instead?
Milan, I'm leaving you in charge of headquarters.
I'll defend it with honor.
Velma, the crumbs on your shirt suggest you've been snacking on the oatmeal raisin cookies again. I advise checking inside the cookie jar for your glasses. Miss Peacock, you help her find them, and we know all about your rap sheet, so please return them to her without any extortion or bribery.
Why? I'd never.
Investigators, let's go.
Hey, everybody, come on. We don't need their rules and their regulations. Yeah. Down with the advanced autocracy.
Yeah!
Freedom for nerds!
Wait, Samuel, why are you wearing gloves in like 100-degree heat?
I'm protesting the heat. Down with conventional weather patterns. Woo!
Crazy thieving sucker. Let's get him.
Why don't you stand back and let a real adventurer handle this?
Immobulus! Honestly, don't you two ever think before you do anything. If he had the magic pen, why would he be resorting to rioting? He could just write it and make it true.
An act. It could be an act, confusing our quest to know fiction from fact.
Where's Sherlock?
Nothing suspicious at all, you say?
Nah, everything's the same as it always is here. Why do you ask?
A magic pen with the power to make the written word real has been stolen from us. We think someone might be using it for evil.
Well, I'll ask around, but like I said, everything's chill here.
I suspect someone from the mathematical profession has stolen the pen.
How did you figure that out?
Well, you see that line the shadow from the building cast that reaches its conclusion there. It runs directly to that window there, where just a moment ago someone was lurking.
Making a quick judgment based on the relative sizes of the other shadows, I've deduced the angle to be 112.358 degrees.
Can you tell me the significance of that?
It's half of 224.716 and twice 56.179.
It is the first six digits of the Fibonacci sequence. Only a mathematician would
orchestrate a move to include those numbers.
Let's check out the staff meeting. Come on, I have an invisibility cloak so they won't notice us. Quick, get under the cloak.
Alright, I need a volunteer for the morning energy drink chugging contest.
I'll do it.
Wait, what?
Well, the kids want energy and fun more than they want morning exercise. Who are we to deprive them of their caffeine when they want that more than running or yoga?
But then we'll have to deal with them in class all day bouncing off the walls instead of doing things like geometric proofs.
I don't see the problem.
Come on, Celia.
Yeah, seriously, I don't want to deal with that all day.
Perhaps my initial assumption was faulty. The math staffers seem to be as bewildered as we are.
Perhaps all of our assumptions are faulty. Perhaps the assumption that we have things to assume is faulty. Perhaps we're all just fantastically faulty ourselves.
Shh. The culprit must be a student. Let's go.
Did the door just open on its own?
Freedom! Freedom from the laws of inertia! Objects at rest should be able to move whenever they want. Let's go!
Settle down! We have a lot of work to get done before the end of the program.
From 9 to 4 with 2 15 segments of class in between. Get ready to have some fun!
Woo! 30 minutes of class every day, that's simply dreadful.
Even I think that's batty as a vampire.
Have you ever met a vampire?
You know, I don't suppose I have. Perhaps I'm not as batty as people say, but I do hear they enjoy a cup of tea cells from time to time.
That girl has something to gain from this chaos.
Hey, check this out.
The clock is ticking. You better find me quick if you want to save this place in your pen.
Not a single fingerprint. What can we conclude from this?
Oh, the thief is a vampire bat!
What on earth are you talking about?
Vampire bats don't have fingers.
No, we can conclude that the perpetrator is wearing gloves to keep from leaving fingerprints. Who do we know that fits this description?
The anarchist.
What about that student?
Just an opportunist.
But that doesn't make any sense. Why would the anarchist start a riot if he had a pen and he could just make things true?
When you have eliminated the impossible, my dear, whatever remains, however improbable, must be the truth.
Attention, vive la résistance! Il faut lutter ensemble ou tomber!
I'll have to catch up with him later.
All right, my fellow revolutionaries, things have gone too far.
Advance is total chaos without any rules. We need to restore order.
Now.
Give it a rest, Sam.
As long as Miss Harriet retains some semblance of order, everything will be just fine.
Miss Harriet, I beg of you, restore things to the way they were, now.
I ain't about to go hollering like some mad dog and get things back like they was. I like the way things is now. Y'all is straight tripping.
What are you writing?
Hey, give it back.
Oh. That's a nice love letter. You spelled interdigitation wrong in the second paragraph, though.
Miss Harriet, no!
You are behind all of this. Throwing down your gloves was just an act. You're the reason for the chaos.
No, I swear on Marx's grave. It wasn't me.
Give me a sample of your handwriting to show that you didn't write this letter.
I can't. I'm illiterate.
You're what?
I always thought that if I worked long enough in advance, I'd learn to read and write. But now that everything's total chaos, I guess I'll never have the chance.
Guys, we can still pull advance back together. If someone's controlling us with a magic pen, we'll have to work extra hard to get advance back on track. Don't you agree?
Aye.
Sounds good, Homeskidding.
May I offer a word of advice? Whoever's been pulling your strings is working up your ranks. Head RA, CRL, assistant director. What I suggest we do is we get the director and lock him up in a safe place.
But where?
We can only hope no villain would try something while he's in such a sanctuary.
Well, I'll stand guard just in case.
Do you stand guard? Like you could fight off a bad guy with a magic pen.
Oh, shut up already, you two. Why don't you both stand guard and leave the rest of us in peace? Aloha mora.
Sorry.
Honestly, can't you drink tea like a normal person? Why would you ever think that cutting a teacup in half and then breakdancing would not end up in spilling tea all over everybody?
Things have gotten better in advance.
Everything seems to be back to normal. We've managed to scare off the perpetrator, but still haven't gotten the pin back.
Maybe it's gone forever.
Half of forever is still forever. And twice of forever is still forever. No matter what you multiply by forever, it's still forever, which means that forever must be the equivalent of zero. And if it's gone for zero time, it means it's not actually gone at all, and it's still somewhere here.
Do you just have a hidden supply of mercury fumes you keep inhaling?
I don't know where else to look for more clues. We might have to go back to our land empty-handed.
You!
Me?
You're the one who's been controlling everyone with a pin! You have the gloves, so you won't leave fingerprints! Expelliarmus!
What was that?
I was trying to disarm you.
Well, I don't know what's going on here, but I'm ready to take these back to Dr. Wood.
Dr. Wood?
Yeah.
He must be the next one they're planning to attack! Locomotor Mortis!
Why can't I move?
Come on, let's go.
What? Wait, I need help!
useless.
I fear we're too late.
I have a rabbit friend who's chronically late.
Indiana Jones and Lara Croft stop fighting and fall asleep. Dr. Wood unlocks the door, goes home, and finally gets a good night's rest, and then advances back the way it should be.
Do you suppose we should tell the advances the truth?
No, let them work it out themselves. We got what we came for. We have our real lives to get back to.
Good, then just enough time for half a cup of afternoon tea.
Wait, there's something else.
P.S. Sam learns to read and write.
I saw her today at the reception. A glass of wine in her hand. I knew she was gonna meet her connection.
What's going on?
I'm hungry. You want to go get some food?
Yeah.
You're buying.
At her feet was a footloose man.
God, it's so hot here. Oh, hey, I need some help. I can't move. And I drank some detergent. Holy shit. But I've been wiggling here for like 3 hours. Dude, I need help. Can't move my legs. Can't move my legs, man. Don't help me.
Good luck with that, though.
What? I need help here. I can't move. I thought we were friends.
You can always get what you want. You can always get what you want. You can always get what you want. But if you try sometime.
I'm sorry about everything that happened.
It's alright, homie.
You might find you get what you need.
Even harder now.
What's up, man?
Oh, thank God. I've been here for like a day. I can't move my legs.
Do you mind if I use your laundry basket?
Oh, yeah, sure, go ahead.
Thanks.
So, about that help. Please.
Good luck with that.
I thought you were my friend, too!
The kids want energy and fun more than they want morning exercise. Who are we to deprive them of their caffeine when they want that more than running or yoga?
But...
Get your director and lock him up in a safe place until we find out who's been doing this.
I swear!
I believe in being uncomfortably honest in public places.
Somebody else should do something, too. Lil' Red, I think you should keep watch for something about wolves.
Hey, I can't move my legs. I need help. Come on. Help me. I can't move my legs, dude. I've been wiggling here for like an hour.
Enough. Lil' Red. You keep your big eyes out, just looking for little wolves as friends sometimes.
Snoring would be funny.
Quick, under the cloak.
Okay, keep Sam with the cloak.
And walk in some direction. Somebody pick a direction and go.
I'm going forward.
Keep walking, keep walking. Walk more toward the building we're in.
Watch
toward- walk toward Bill.
Walk toward the stack.
Keep walking.
Okay. Freedom! Freedom from the laws of inertia. Objects at rest to be able to move whenever they want. Let's go!
Enough. Little Red, you keep your big eyes out. Look searching for friends dressed as wolves. I mean, wolves dressed as friends. Because I'm really messing up right now and I'm very sorry.
I'm not going to tell him to stop. I'm just going to let him go.
Oh, hey! Hey, can I
get some help? I moved my legs. I think I hurt you tomorrow. Dude, I've been waiting like 5 hours. I can't move. Let's not do this. Oh, God.
Get dizzy eventually.
I beg of you.
I ain't about to go hollering like a mad dog and get it back like it was. I like the way things is now.
Y'all are straight tripping.
Crikey. Dr. Hogan is She was just thinking about when you snored the time before. It was still funny. Mad Hatter, okay?
No! My elbow beat my face! Did you videotape that?
I don't think I got her falling, but I got her groaning. Alright, can we do that one more time?
I'm so